Welcome to WatchGuard Security Week in Review, a video podcast that typically summarizes the biggest information and network security stories each week and that shares some practical security advice along the way. I'm your host and all-around security nerd, Corey Nachreiner, and this is the episode for the week starting September 23rd, 2013. This week I'm traveling to attend IceFog Security Conference here in the Windy City of Chicago. I was really hoping to bring you a full episode, but my travel schedule simply prevented me from doing all that production. Instead, I'm going to post a text version of our weekly security summary on the WatchGuard Security Center blog. So if you normally go to YouTube to see this video, be sure to visit the blog to hear about the latest security stories this week. Nonetheless, I'll quickly summarize the top stories I plan on covering. First of all, if you use Cisco iOS, they've released a lot of updates, mostly to fix DOS flaws. Go get them. Kaspersky this week released some details about a new APT campaign called IceFog. It's a small group of attackers that are typically going after South Korean and Japanese government organizations, telecom, military contractors, and things like that. I'll talk about that in the blog as well. Also, we learned earlier in the week that the iPhone 5's fingerprint scanner has already been hacked. Members from the Computer Chaos Club in Germany used some very old-school fingerprint hacking techniques and proved that they worked against the iPhone 5S. Be sure to check out the video link I post of that particular hack. Also, there's been a significant uptick in extortion ransomware, specifically one called FileCoder, or also CryptoLocker, depending on who you ask. So read about that in the blog. And finally, Brian Krebs broke a story about how attackers gain access to some data brokers' networks and are now selling a lot of our personal information to the underground market. So again, if you want the details on these stories, be sure to check out the WatchGuard Security Center blog, where I'll post the text version of this week's episode. Also, check out our blog for more regular security stories. You can also follow me on Twitter, I'm at SecAdept, or follow WatchGuard at WatchGuard Tech. As always, thank you for watching, and here at WatchGuard, we're rooting for you.